Hi, I'm Phillipe and I'm a third year Bachelor of Biomedical Science student here at Monash. And today I'm going to be interviewing two recent biomedical science graduates to find out where their degree has taken them and what their profession career looks like right now. So I'm here with Cody and Eleonora here today. And could you please introduce yourselves and tell us a little bit about yourselves?
My name is Eleonora and I'm currently working as a technical and research officer at the World Mosquito Program. It's a non-for-profit initiative that aims to protect the global community from mosquito-borne diseases, so think Zika, dengue and chikungunya. The program currently exists in 12 countries, but I'm part of the Oceania Hub, so I'm based here at Monash Clayton in the Institute of Vector-Borne Disease.
My current role is a consultant at EY. I'm part of the digital health team. I'm focusing on digital health strategy work and also program assurance review for large-scale healthcare IT implementation programs.
Essentially, can you tell me what your career pathway has been like? So how did you get to where you are now and essentially how your degree has helped you as well?
Yes, I graduated in 2017 from Monash with Bachelor of Biomedical Science and Bachelor of Commerce. But like many other students, I started Bachelor of Biomedical Science with the end goal of going into graduate medicine. But I think throughout the four-year journey and the degree, I realised that I actually wanted to combine the two skill sets, the commercial and the health interest of mine, and apply for graduate roles. So in my penultimate year, I started exploring commercial options that could combine these interests. And I kind of landed on a health-related graduate role at an organisation called Cerner Corporations. So I was there for almost 2 years implementing electronic medical records across the Asia-Pacific region, specialising in the surgery and anaesthesia solution. So 1 year ago, I also then moved to EY as an experienced digital health consultant. So now I've shifted my focus from implementation background to more of a digital health strategy background.
By the time I finished my degree, I was actually thinking I might want to have a look at doing my PhD or going into academia instead. I was really lucky that I found a position that was going at World Mosquito Program, and it was only for, you know, like an assistant to come in a couple days a week or whatever. And I was like, you know, this will be just a foot in the door, see what the industry is like. And I'm now full-time there, which is great. And I've had a lot more responsibility. So now I'm in the officer role. And the programs continue to grow and the Oceania hubs continue to grow as well. So it's been really amazing sort of starting from quite like a technical hands-on position and then getting to a point where you can sort of oversee things from a different perspective, I guess. You can sort of see the effects you're having internationally and things. So that's been really great.
So what I've understood is that straight out of biomedicine, you went into the kind of mosquito research and you've been there ever since.
Spot on. Yeah.
What has been the most rewarding aspect of your role?
I think just being at the forefront of changing how healthcare is delivered and defining like the future direction to create efficiencies and cost savings is probably the most rewarding part of the role. Like, of course, not every day is all... I can't say exactly today I was forefront of changing how healthcare is delivered, but I think at the end of the project, I can see that I'm actually making a difference to the community is really important to me.
I think ultimately one of the really special things is that it's a lab where, you know, you're not waiting years and years to release a product. You're being able to see the effect that you have on communities in real time. And that's actually really rewarding and really great. You can sort of see numbers of kind of protected places increasing, and you know, especially when you sort of touch base with other sites internationally and you can sort of hear firsthand how things are going. There's probably, I reckon it's going to be the highlight.
Honing in on Monash now, I'd like to ask, how did your time at Monash set you up and help you for your roles?
A lot of my experience from during my studies kind of conveyed and transferred towards professional work quite well. But most recently, I conducted a research piece on out-of-hospital models of care for chronic disease management, which I actually found really similar to the systematic review we did as part of our fourth year biomedical Science capstone unit.
That's what I'm doing.
I remember that one.
Yeah.
Big assignment. Yeah.
Yeah, it was a big assignment. And at the time, I was like, oh, there's no point in doing this. Like, it doesn't make any sense. Like, but then when it came to doing this piece for a government agency, I actually started using a lot of the same processes and structures that I used throughout the systematic review. It's funny how a lot of things that we did in the fourth year, the capstone years I felt were very comprehensive in terms of the skills they brought together.
Definitely. I feel like that's a perfect way to end this interview. So I'd just like to thank you so much for sharing your career insights and your time as well. And I essentially wish you all the best for wherever your careers take you.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
So thank you for joining us today. And hopefully you got some insight into biomedical science and essentially where a biomedical degree can take you. And if you think biomedicine's for you, I hope that we'll see you next year.